Okay, perfect. Now, this is SimCity for Super NES, which I think is one of the better versions of SimCity ever released. I thought I turned off the music, but whatever. Anyways, let me go ahead and I'm gonna go ahead and save here, and then now that I've got it where I want it, I'm gonna go ahead and see what I can do here. Now I have to play with a regular Super NES controller, and these don't really like to work in the Retron 5. So what I'm doing here first is I'm scanning where I wanna put my power plants, and where I would like to put my power plants is somewhere that has minimal plant growth. Now, can't put the power plants all clustered in one area, in my opinion, but I guess it can be done. I don't see why not. So, first off, the way to build roads in this game is, like, totally different than anything you might be thinking here. That's why I'm going with the railroad here. And it's not a train like in SimCity 2000 or 3000 even, or other SimCities, I should say. All right, what I have here now is that. Crime is going to get pretty high around this, and that's a problem. So the best way to counteract this after... okay, so they're all powered into each other, but the best way to counteract this, actually, is, believe it or not, and, no, you don't have to do what I'm doing here. But this is the only way, in my opinion, to counteract, the crime problem that will develop with having an industrial area. That's what I've noticed about SimCity. Now, in order to build skyscrapers and stuff, that has to be based on land scarcity and how the land is going to be built. Now, here's a little thing here. I don't necessarily want to build a bridge or anything going across, because there's really nothing to go across, in my opinion. So I go ahead and I'll do that. And then surrounded here by police stations, I go ahead and since this is an industrial area, go right on ahead and you can never have too many fire stations or police stations in this version of SimCity. Now see, by putting an industrial there, what's going to happen, if I put a residential next to it, it's going to bring down the land. So what has to be done, and there's two ways to build. This is one way to build. This is the gridding method. And then there's a different way to build. People don't want to live too far away from industry. So, knowing that, let me go right on ahead here. Knowing that, see, that's pretty far away from an industrial zone, that particular industry there. So, to buoy up some industry. Now, when there's no roads, just build a fire station. And but you gotta have, or I recommend putting the police departments here like that, because I mean it's just absolutely amazing how crime will shoot up, pollution will shoot up. Now, here's something else. So if I don't want to if I don't want to build, do this. Put parks. Now, if I want something in particular design, I go here until, I go here till I get trees. And when the tree finally shows up, then do my best not to override it, obviously. But when the tree finally shows up, then leave it. So that's the reason for the unlimited money code. The way to play this, if I didn't want to do the unlimited money code, is like, for instance here, instead of putting industrial, money's no object right now. But then, if I don't want to put industrial there, you know, I can put a park here. I can even use those trees as a design. All it does is it buoys up the value. Now, by moving up the value of the property, allegedly the parks will cut down on pollution and stuff like that. Now, the other thing here is, you know, look at where I am. So, in order to get some gifts, what we want is, we want a bunch of gifts. So, the first gifts we can get would be, park space. So, go ahead, develop everything into parks. Try to leave the woodlands to have higher value. Now, this is something that actually works in the city of Las Vegas, but I really can't speak for any other town on Earth. And yes, Minecraft has a lot of common, especially in the creative part. Now, it is possible to draw with the park or the bulldoze feature, depending on how the drawing wants to be made. There's other things like you can get offered a casino or an amusement park. Those are what we call gifts. Library. Don't get a bank. A person does not earn the user. I'll restore that to a tree. A user doesn't earn a bank in SimCity for Super NES. I don't know anything about SimCity on computer. Though I do have multiple copies of the original SimCity on computer, I just don't play it enough to know how scenarios and stuff play out. That's all. So I don't know if a user gets a bank or not. And I'm hoping this video doesn't get flagged for anything, claim or strike or whatever. Now, the reason for the park space is I should be getting a prize. There's a way to debug the game, or just use a game genie that unlocks everything. And those are easier ways to also play the game. But I prefer just doing the $1 million code. It's I think it's literally $1 shy of $1 million. And if I need more money later, I just do the code again. In the meantime, other easy-to-get gifts, right off the bat. Mayor's House just reached a population of 2,000. What else? I don't know. Is there a zoo, or am I thinking of SimCity 2000? There's, another thing is to buoy up commercial properties, is build stadiums, though if citizenry demands stadiums, then that's a different story. And there's one other thing I'd like to do, even though I turned on auto budget. Okay, I'm going to leave that there. You know. So, oh, damn. I thought that was a stadium. I don't know. I mean, a football helmet. Come on, that's a stadium. Okay, now there are two different stadiums here, and I'm building just this one. With the stadiums have the same problem as doing what I did with nuclear plants. So, go ahead and build it like a nuclear plant. I'm actually demolishing two of these to get domes. But right now, this will do just fine. And then go ahead and do what I did before, which is build these ridiculous blocks. Industry will not demand a second airport, so there's not really any danger of that happening again. Danger. Well, it's not really a danger. I don't know why I said danger. That's not danger. We need to stop using that kind of stuff. Because, again, these are toys. So, nothing here is dangerous. I mean, yeah, I do flip out when things don't go my way in a game. And that's actually something I'm not proud of. Because I shouldn't be doing that. Okay. So right now I just need this one to go all the way across to connect the power. But I do like having redundancy, so this part here would be redundant. And with industry, it's okay to have a lot of industry, actually, because even if industry goes down, it can always rebound up. So my question is, which way do I want industry to go here? Because I gotta hold. I don't know if I'm gridding it up underneath this stuff. I know that this is what I'm doing here. I'm gonna leave that park by the airport though, because we have Sunset Park by the airport in Las Vegas. So it's kind of based on my understanding of it. This is not Las Vegas. Las Vegas is in this game though. As weird as that sounds, but this is not at all Las Vegas. Also, I don't know how long y'all want to watch someone play SimCity. It's, you know, I mean, come on, it's not an action game or anything like that. I mean, I have SimCity 2000 downloaded on the PS3. It's not like, you know, you want to watch that either. That's just as boring. I also cheated on that to get a $1 million code. The truth is that's how we wish anything would be, just unlimited money. So that's where it comes in as a game. If I don't want to play as a serious game, I can do that. That's my privilege. That's my right. And I don't see anything in particular wrong with wanting to play that way. Knowing that, I do see something wrong that... Don't we all wish? Yeah, we wish. Let's see here. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and going to build the industry. I guess I could build the industry entirely around. Like, I only need one seaport, one airport. Hell, I only need one stadium. I don't actually need four stadiums. That's just something I like to do for cosmetic effect. Because way down here is where I'm putting four more nuclear plants, but I'll still get brownouts. And why? I don't know. The game's always been played like that. Now, as far as roads go, what I actually need to do is go next to every single square and put roads. So what I do is I just ignore that because everything will be built anyways. I mean, what is the damned use of, you know, having roads when it doesn't actually affect the rise and fall of the game here. It's just something I've always wondered myself, that's all. I'm not telling you how to play the game. I'm not telling me anything. I'm just saying that this is how I've played the game my whole life. Yeah, I guess that's fairly accurate. I've played this game most of my life, since I was 11 years old, on the Super NES. See, that works out to my taste. Yeah, I know I'm trampling over the forests and stuff, but whatever. And then again, I know it seems like this is a waste of money, but when I have money to waste, I can waste the money. And when you look at it, it's not really that gigantic of a city. I couldn't tell you what the estimation is or anything. An acre is not a square. So I'm not really sure what an acre is, to be honest. I know Phil lives on 1.7 or 1.8 acres. That's about it. I owned a quarter acre. I mean, I owned exactly a quarter acre when I lived out in Pahrump. So, again, I don't know what an acre is. Now, realistically, yes, these would need roads, dirt roads, stuff like that. I mean, there's always room to improve. And there's actually a SimCity clone. I think it's called Cities or something, or Skyline, something along those lines. And that game is out. Now, the reason to put all industry on the edge like this, not only to have a large industrial border, a buffer zone, but a lot of the pollution will then go off screen. And that's a smart move. Because then I can install things like a green belt zone. You know, I don't have to build to the grid. This game is built completely to the grid, minus one row of pixels up and down. So, you know, like if I wanted to put something here, knowing that I need to have a railroad there, and then I can go ahead and what can I build? Well, I can build more stadium. Well, that way it all looks uniform. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and build industrial areas. And then I'm going to do that green belt idea because I like it. Now, I can actually put the seaport where one of the stadiums would be. I know that sounds weird. And I don't have to put the seaport on the water. I know that sounds odd, but it can actually be done. So, what I'll do here is, I'm going to come back and I'm going to make both of those domed stadiums. I'm not going to do it right now. Because if I do it right now, yeah, I know that seems weird. All it does is, it'll just keep giving me the same stadium. So, what I have to do is, like, wait till, like, February or something, and see if that works. And again, just overwhelm it with police presence. Crime and pollution are the two things that will do a person in when playing this game. In my experience. Everyone can play this game any way they want, and maybe they can get away with things like crime and pollution not affecting how their city functions and so forth and so on. Good for them. This is how I played it. This is how a few of my friends played it. We Censored is one of those friends. There's other people I don't want to talk about on this show. Maybe for legal reasons. Maybe for other reasons. Whatever. It doesn't really leave a lot of space for industry down here. So I'm going to stick to the grid design. Now that's the other thing. Do I want to stick to the grid? I mean, you know, looking at this. Well, I guess I could. And we can see how well it holds up, but, I mean, you know, in all seriousness and honesty. The one way to get rid of tsunamis in this game is to develop all the seacoast. And the other thing I recommend is developing all the land, all the available land, into park space. Leaving just the wild trees. Yeah, where the wild things are. See, this works out because I get me a police station right there, and then I can develop park space all around it. Too bad I can't put a fire station there. But that's how that looks. I don't develop on the islands then. Because, you know, to me there's no reason to. And this makes a particular challenge when developing anything. So what I'm going to do is what I have been doing. We go ahead, or I go ahead, you know, take this and run it across. So, you know, where industry resides, industry transforms. Which makes me worry about some civilizations on this planet that try to transform their old, dirty industrial areas into something clean. And, you know, will it ever be clean? Well, yeah, I can't answer that for you. You know. And if we want, let's go ahead and try to get, trees. Don't feel the need that anything I'm doing, you would have to do if you played this game. This is stuff that I do. And I keep repeating that because it's important to know that we all play differently. We all see things differently, especially in games like SimCity, Minecraft, or any of these creation games. For a while they were called God games, but you know, I'm actually not God here. I'm a city council with a mayor. And particularly the role taken as mayor. I mean, they even say that. I mean, I guess I could develop the whole city. As you can tell, once I get rolling here, I actually got the experience, even muscle memory, to do it. Now, see, then we run into a little bit of fun, a little bit of challenge here. Like, how do we make the grid work out here? I really don't care if the railroads connect or not. I don't even have to connect to this island. Let's see here. You know, I don't have to have this island connect to anything. Really. The good part is the park spaces don't attract any crime that I know of. So, you know, then here could be something, residential, whatever. The one thing I know about this game is, let's see, can I, yes I can, do that. But can I do that here? Yes, I can. So that works out for all the wrong reasons. and go ahead and develop the block. Develop the rest of it. Because I'm not building anything here. And that's not a way to get to Megaopolis. And without using a game genie, I have never gotten Megaopolis status in this game. Can it be done? I suppose so. It's in the game files on the cartridge. But I have never gotten it. I don't know what I've done wrong for so many years, but I guess it's something. So here I am. Okay, so the whole area there is mostly done. Just got to put some industrial here to finish it up. And, yuck, don't go swimming in that lake. you get criminals' poop or you get industrial sludge. I guess whatever will float your boat, right? Knowing nothing. And I'm looking at that, and that's another scenario where it's, no, that just won't happen. And like, okay, well, am I giving away prime real estate here? Maybe. All I know is the one time I did see someone have a Megaopolis in this game, it was because they had nothing but skyscrapers everywhere. And I've never achieved that, though I do know how to build a skyscraper is by rarity. Make the property rare. Now, the question is, with here, okay, so this is, the whole outline is developed, plus the airport. Now what? Right? Okay, so this is where this comes in. What I want is a buffer zone. So that's the buffer zone. Have the buffer zone connect like that. The only thing we'll go through the buffer zone is railroads and electricity. Still have to have police departments. No, I'm not going to put the police departments in the buffer zones. That wouldn't make much sense to me. All right, let me just have this come all the way, nearly all the way down. I don't want it to go all the way down. But I do want it to go down. Ew. That's not what I meant. All right. Okay, so I have that, and then well, I guess I can have this one. Lake is in the way here, kind of. It is and it isn't. Okay, I'm not going. I guess I could. All right. So, like I said, this requires a little bit of thought. But I don't want to build anything within the buffer zone. And this will all be park space. Ooh, did I make it? I just made it there. And here is a bit of a strange scenario. Because, the track is supposed to go according to my grid plan. Now, the grid plan kind of makes it inorganic, but the game itself is a tad rigid, just due to the age of when it came out. Okay, now you see, so the problem here is simple. The airport would interrupt the buffer zone, right? Well, not necessarily. So, let me figure it out. Whoops. We know that's the fourth one there. Comes up here. That's gonna suck. I'm gonna do the same thing here. Luckily, there's nothing there. It bothers me if I go over a tree that I didn't plan on to. So, it's not completely to the gridded plan here. Well, that's okay by me. Other things can be built in these sections. But the idea is to have scarcity and rarity, and I've always tried to figure out how to do that. Never been very good at it. Okay, according to this, I missed. I guess I did, but that's okay. See, no harm done. Park space is back. The trees aren't real. So don't worry about deforestation. Although in SimCity 2000, they'll complain if that's done. Okay, so that's pretty much that. So what I want to do here is this, another loop. I mean, if someone's going to cause crime on the railroad tracks in this game, okay, more power to them, I guess. Whatever. I understand this one's going to look a little weird, so that would be the place to actually start. But maybe weird is good, right? So, here we go. This will be the buffer zone. A green belt, if you will. And I'm playing this without sound effects, so if there's any sound effects that come off as annoying or whatever, oh well, tough tamales. Not really much I'm going to do about it. Alright. Okay, that works out. Let's go down this way. Not really a let's here, but trying to think here as I do this, what would I like? Should I let the community, or not the community, well, each community would be, you know, like this, 3 by 3, 9 squares. So how would I want the skyscraper neighborhoods to look? Well, what I would like is to have one gift and a police station. I think that would be the best way to do it. Alright, I was going to find out about this one, right? So, let me see here. Can I do that? I think I can. Yeah, that works out. Since it's, you know, I don't know how I'm building around this lake yet. No, I do know how I'm building around the bushes. Well, shrubbery is probably the better word. This is shrubbery, right? Now, this keeps the pollution also away from the whatever I'm going to build here. Like I said, I just haven't figured out what I'm going to build. The other thing is patience. Want to make everything a skyscraper? Patience. There's absolutely no way to force a skyscraper. Land value has to be particularly high to force a skyscraper in this game. So, I'm not really sure how to do that. I forgot how many police and... Whoops, let's restore that tree. How many police and fire I need to get a headquarters. The headquarters are supposed to be spread out, but I don't do that. Because they're gifts. And in this game's mentality, having those as a gift means that it increases the value of the property that surrounds it. Okay, make sure it's all park space. Oh yeah, okay. All right, now, next up here is the save. So I'm going to go ahead and save. And before I turn on the scenario, as I take a look here, where do I want these skyscrapers to be? Well, the best place to start is probably either right here or at the airport. And so that is an actual question, you know, where do I want the skyscrapers to be? So I'm not I'm not really. I'm just going to kind of build haphazardly here. I'm not really going to be building to any specific reasoning. All I know is I've got to have police departments littering the area, and then I can put gifts, you know, in near the area as well. Like here, this works out. And when I get a mayor's house, I can put the mayor's house here and something else here. In the meantime, we do want people to live here and develop it. And with all the industry, there's going to be more demand for residential. So try to keep the residential in areas that can increase in value. So there I made a mistake, and I made another one. But I'll go ahead and fix that by making it residential. Yeah, it doesn't hurt to do that. It won't. It won't hurt it because it can't hurt it. All that will do is just increase the value. All I have to do is have it touch one of the blocks. And then I don't really mind this city not being too dense. It doesn't bother me. You know, that'd be better served. Yes, that would be better served with a commercial property or something like that. But I'm not doing that. I'm doing this. And, you know, if I wanted commercial property, there is a better, different way of doing it. And since it already has that, what I can do is I can go that much over. And I can actually put commercial right here. And we obviously we want police presence wherever we can get it. Or I do, anyways. Now, the issue here is simple. Commercial's gotta have the ability, I'll do that because I can always undo it later. And then give it some development down here. Do our best to try to keep the forest. And then get the power all hooked up here. Let's develop this. Now this will be where the town will be, and then I'll be deciding where the gifts go. So, first one here, let's do that. And that. And this will go right across over to the airport. And then, let's see. What do I want to? No, right through the middle. And that's good. Now, again, before I do anything, well, I wish I had more than two save slots, but that is the limitation of the Super NES. Okay. And now we watch. That's it. I can now build a police headquarters. All right. That's where I'm putting it. Right there. Okay. Let's see what else it... Build another police headquarters. Where to put it? Well, let me put it right here. We'll see, why not? Okay. And I can build a third police headquarters. Now, that's the thing. These are gifts. I don't mind having all three headquarters in one place. The problem later that comes up in this game is the gifts eventually run out. So I've got this. I'm going to hold on to the fire headquarters for the moment. And another fire headquarters. Another way to play this game is to see where the brown is to actually destroy the... I'm going to get a mayor's house here in a minute. I know exactly where I'm putting it. I'll handle the stadiums as soon as I get my house. Okay. Right there. Alright. Yeah, about those stadiums. I prefer a large park. Oh, wait just a minute here. See? So I told you. If I wait, I can put a domed stadium. Don't worry about the gifts. The gifts will always come back. Going all the way down here, I don't want these outdoor stadiums. It's an industrial area. So what I want to go ahead and do is the same thing. Try to get domed stadiums. I just prefer the look of the domed stadiums, that's all. Alright, so I may have overbuilt residential here. So like I was about to say, yeah, I can go through and I can demolish the housing until I get all high-class housing. You know, they're saying they want more commercial property. Okay, that's cool. Let's give it to them like this. And then to ensure that it does well, we can do that. Put some commercial. Hold on, put some commercial here. I'm going to leave with to help. Drive the land value way, way up there. And that's that. The land value is going to go up pretty high wherever there's a gift. Build another large park. More commercial zones are needed. That's what I'm being told. So, let me do the same thing again, in a weird way. Okay, ooh, a train station. Train stations are a tad difficult. Let me go ahead and... because they have all this line connection, so a good spot for the train station would be like that. Commercial properties and expos. No, not that one. Here. Do this. And I need, cops there. Okay. Alright, get that hooked up. Some parts built. And see what happens. So that's the only way to do the train station, because I don't think I can build... Oh, I guess I can. And it's still hooked up. Okay, I've never done that before, so... So as you can tell here, we've got some viable commercial property right here. And this is viable residential here. But these are almost ghetto. Now I'm being told to build more residential zones, so provide a green belt here. Put a fire station there. Put two more residential here. Oh, yeah, that's correct. Okay. Then I want to put a fire headquarters right here. And then do something a little bit different here. No, that's not different enough. The expo here. Remember, those railroad tracks absolutely have to be connected one way or another. I don't mean that as a Blondie song. They absolutely have to be connected. I'm not going to have it go through there, so let's develop this in the parkland. Some parkland here, and some parkland here. The obsession with parkland is, that's A-OK stuff. I mean, all it's going to do is just make it a nicer place to live. This is only going to go on for an hour. I was hoping some skyscrapers would develop. I mean, I don't mean that. I mean, those are high rises. No, SimCity has, according to Hoyle, skyscrapers. Okay, so this is not increasing the value here, or this, and this isn't doing anything. That happens. I have an overabundance of lots. I have an overabundance of gifts. I mean, I still have a park. If I want to increase value, I suppose, like here, and have a skyscraper come in, instead of leaving it like that, I put the park there. So then it has three gifts surrounding one group of residential. And, so there is a zoo. And the question is, you know, where to put these? Try to figure it out as I go along here. You know, it could be the game sees shrubbery, woodlands, as undeveloped. And that's the other problem. See, I don't have anything down here. The industrial is going to stay like that. The nice part about that is getting lots to use. Commercial's down. So when commercial's down, we have to start looking at, you know, what do we want to do here? Well, I'm going to leave it down. I'm going to let it go down so that this residential can pick up in value. Will it happen in the next, 11 minutes before I finish this? Well, you know, I'm actually going to exit out of the game. And we'll have the moon going. But in the meantime, yeah, you know. Like, this worked here. The zoo here increased the value here. It went from brown now to this. In fact, this went from brown to estates, to ranch houses, to now it's going to whatever. The park here is working its magic. You got these here that are going to turn into these. And this is going to turn into a skyscraper. Let's see, what else? But I'm not having the magic here. I don't have any more gifts. You know, this turned into ghetto right here, and yet it's right next to a gift. I totally messed up right here. Okay. Alright, there. That's better. Okay, so even though I have this here, it's still pretty bad. It's not going up in value. Oh, that went down because I built that. So you can't guess these things. It's either going to go or it's not going to go. Everything, the build two, up, down, left, right, whatever. And the reason for building two is so the skyscrapers can be built horizontal or vertical. Now, those are the words I've been trying to think of all day. And that's to me, is the only way to make any progress in this game, is doing what I just said. Is, you know, everything's kind of got to be scarce. And, you know, it's not happening in the time I would like. I really don't want to go over an hour, but I do want to show you all a skyscraper, another zoo. So, when we have a problem like this right here, where it's ghetto, put another gift. As I've stated, the problem can be exacerbated instead of improved upon, because what might happen, I'm not saying it will happen, but what might happen is it just won't do anything. It'll just be a waste to put a gift like that. You know, should have these been on the water? Probably. But I didn't put it on the water. And this is ghetto here. And because I did this, it affected this commercial zone. I'm being told there's more commercial zones needed. I see two that are completely undeveloped. There's no excuse for this. There's a mayor's house, and there's a park, and there's a police department. Could it be the pollution from the airports coming down over here and ruining the value? You know, we got a rich commercial here, but nothing here. And I don't have any more gifts right now. Ah, see? See, it's changing. It's changing right here. Now, sometimes, see, the way I built this is these two might be developed into a skyscraper, and then this will have to develop into just a singular skyscraper. Same with this. The expo here is supposed to build up commercial value overall. These two will probably go skyscraper. Wow, right in front of me. You saw that? That's the programming here keeps the game kind of unpredictable. Look, this went back down to brown. Brown is poop. So my time's ticking here. I'm sure you can look at someone else's video and say, oh, well, that's cool. This went down. Yeah, no. Not till I see everything here densely packed will I build any more zones. Oh wow. Okay, I've got a major problem here. Let me Well, it can't be the crime rate. Let me see here. All right. Let me try that. No, I am. Okay. And, shoot. See, I don't. Redskins. Okay, try something here. Oh boy. Okay. There should be plenty of police presence at that particular location. Locations. Here. Okay. Got one more. All right. Let's see what that does. Shoot. That was yeah, okay. I've overbuilt commercial. Wow. wanted commercial because of the airport, but that may be a bad idea right at this moment. Make it residential. And, I don't know if that did, if that's going to do anything here. Let me try that. Police station there. It up to power and go ahead and develop this. I guess the best way you can see it is like a lake or something. A school develop. Now, schools, and in SimCity 2000, churches develop and stuff. Wreck a church or swear or something along those lines, and the game will punish the user. All right, let me see what scenarios. I guess they'd need a school. See if that's given a boom. A hospital's just as bad, in my opinion. I know that sounds weird. You know, we don't want things like that. Nope. Trying to just leave it here for a moment. Looking, I got a little over 3 minutes here. I do want to call it quits at an hour. For this game, I don't know. I wanted to give Warhammer another shot, but I'm behind on because of things. I'm just behind on videos that were made yesterday. All right, looks like certain commercial properties are. Or booming once again. See, when using the free land, which is earned by defeating all the scenarios in the game, when using free land on the Super NES version, all that develops is the B team. This is the early stages of the B team right here. The brown, the poop colored one, that's the B team. The A team is this white, grayish white, beige stuff. That's what we want. Not counting schools and hospitals. Like this. This is the A team. This is the A team. That's the B team. See, this is perfect right here. So far. This is not. This is perfect. This is not. Is there a Game Genie code that would, alleviate or resolute this? I don't know. Because I've never looked. The idea is to just make... try to think of the people who live in this fictitious town that you build or I'm building in a SimCity game. Try to think of them as real people. Try to think of them like that. Give them the due credit for that. They, you know, if you've seen Reboot, you know what I'm talking about. They could... In fact, to be honest to God people, after all, they built a hospital and a school, and if this was the PC version, there would also be a church. Now I'm being told I need more commercial, but the bonus here is, if I need more commercial, that means residential is doing fine. But where do they all work? Everything's so spread out. Now, when things start building up more and more and more and more in this game, then yeah, it's then it's most likely to transform into things like that. Okay, I'm going over an hour here. I just want to show you guys a skyscraper. That's all I'm trying to do here. I want to use one of these houses as an example. So watch. I demolish their house. I know that that's eminent domain and that's wrong. Then we wait. A house will show up. And if it's a brown house, then go ahead and demolish it. Like, you know, if I don't want these houses right next to me, I can do that. And we'll see what crops up. It's weird. You know. Okay, so another brown one showed up. But if I get rid of their houses... Okay, so it's still telling me more residential zones are needed, but... Okay, now you see that? See, look what's popping up. Ranch houses. And there it is. You know, that's what we want. We want the ranch style houses. Still no skyscrapers. There still aren't any skyscrapers. I should say that using proper English. As long as I don't sever a power line, I can go ahead and get away with this to a large degree. I mean, look at that. But this one still didn't develop into what I want. But that did. Where was the other one? Was this the other one? No, that wasn't the other one. But there was another one. That one's too late. That one's fully developed as poo-poo. No, you all ain't gonna do that. Oh, did this just downgrade in front of me? Or did it upgrade? I don't know. Quit rebuilding your house. I know that's mean. No. We're gonna build ranch style houses here, folks. Okay, see, that's what's happening here. I'm sorry I've gone over an hour. Just waiting for a skyscraper to form. And then I'm done here. Oh, I just realized, yeah, I don't have to do that on this. I don't have to do it on this version or the Wii U Virtual Console version. Cool. I forget about these things sometimes. Come on. Somebody build a skyscraper. People are wondering, why do you keep demolishing our house, Mr. Mayor? Well, because I don't want brown houses. I want houses that are not brown. Here, I don't really have a choice, otherwise I'll lose power. It's all about electricity. So, this is tedious, but yes, you will keep, if you want to do what I'm doing. The battle will continue until I get the house I want. Why would the house not develop here? I don't know. It could be something as simple as this. Believe it or not. I wouldn't know why. Honestly. I didn't program this game. I didn't develop this game. I have nothing to do with the scenarios that are presented. All I know is how to play the game. And this is where I guess the moniker or the classification of saying, well, SimCity is a god game is because I can go in and get that. But that's a government thing. Aha! All right, we are done here. There's a skyscraper. That's what I wanted to show you was a skyscraper. So finally got a skyscraper built. And that's a commercial skyscraper. And, you know, that is what needs to be built throughout the entire game. And practically somehow in every possible block. And there's a residential skyscraper that just formed right in front of us. That's exactly what needs to be built. This is as built as it's going to get. This one's going to turn into a skyscraper here. these all have that potential too. The way to do that is to build up more commercial at a slow pace. And so, all right, okay, I'm done. That's coffeeforbinky@gmail.com if you want to send an email or anything. COFFEE, the number 4, BINKY@gmail.com. And if you want to send to my Patreon or something, it'd be really appreciated. So I'm going to save, and that will be that. So you all have a good night or a good day or whatever you're doing.